Hi, my name's Kent. I'm the creative specialist on the Google Web Designer team, and I'd like to show how to use the template gallery and easy mode templates in Google Web Designer. Here's the start screen. I can use a template now, or always access the same anytime from File, New from Template. I'll see about 100 layouts or designs, and most are in multiple sizes or responsive. These are arranged in groups that can be collapsed. If you've saved your own templates, they'll be found in My Templates, and you can further update the metadata and edit or use them. Back in the template gallery, mine are sorted by most used, but you can change that, and you can filter the list on a search term, like swirl, or the map component, or a plain banner, and refine your results with these checkboxes, for example, the serving platform. Notice some of these have an easy mode badge, which is a completely different authoring environment. It's intended to make things quick and easy, to just swap out your own content and publish. Let's try this one, Standard Banner Build Slide. I'll give it a name, and here for mode is where you'll want to select Easy Mode if you want to work this way. And I'll just point out before creating it that I could preview this file first and choose a size and browser if I wanted. Now in Easy Mode, I see all sizes and the animation. The things I can change are all here on the left, simple stuff like logos, images, text, and colors, and this makes it very easy to customize your file. Starting with size, I can turn off any I don't need. Now I add my own logo by just dragging it onto this icon, or you can use the file system if you prefer, and same for the main image. Next are all my text elements, and there's a lot of control. First I'll update my CTA text. I'll leave the font, weight, and color for now, but here's the font size, which can be a little tricky to work with. For example, I'll knock it down to 8, but see it's only affecting some sizes, not the mobiles, where it's still larger. That's because text fitting is enabled on all text elements, so if my content is longer, then it'll shrink to fit. And the value I'm changing here only affects the maximum font size in the base document. That means any size with a responsive override will ignore this value. Bottom line is there are some limitations with font size in easy mode, so I'll restore it to 14. I'll skip down to the headline and change that text. Now I'll change the font. I'll click More Fonts and use Montserrat, which is wider, and I can search for any other Google font if I don't see it listed here. OK closes the dialog. And note the new fonts bring along all their variants, so I can choose any of these styles now. I'll change the text color. It's nice that the colors are shown in real time on stage as I change them in the color picker. I'll enter a hex value and tab key, then click outside the color panel to close it. Same changes for the subhead text, and you could just leave this blank if you didn't want a subhead. Next are all the shape colors, which is pretty self-explanatory, although I'll point out they all have opacity sliders. I'll set my background to bright white, light gray for the accent. Again, I could just make it empty or the same color as the background if I didn't need it, and the CTA button. And last is the exit URL, which I set to my own landing page. Once I've made all my changes, I could select individual sizes and apply different styles to them. In the top left corner of each size, the check icon turns yellow to select, and I can add more. I'll just pick these two, and now I can update these sizes only, at least for the settings not grayed out. For example, copy the CTA color and update my headline to match. Then just deselect these to return to normal editing. At this point, you might be done. Along the top menu bar, I can play the animation and save it. Skipping over to preview, I see the usual options about which browser, sharing links, and previewing on a device. Same for publish, all the usual options. In this case, I'd push directly to display in Video 360. A couple tips for working with easy mode templates. If you're having trouble with your images looking too small, then make sure they're trimmed close to the artwork and don't include empty space. Also, this particular layout tends to work best with squarish logos and images. But other easy mode templates have different image aspect ratios and scaling options, like fill instead of contain like this one. so you might want to give them a try before going into standard mode. But some changes will require it, like maybe I want to add a second image in this wide banner, or reduce the button height on these tall mobiles, or make the logo bigger on the square sizes. These are all cases for the final control, standard mode. This is a one-way trip. Once you convert, you can't reopen a file in easy mode. Here's how it works. First, I'll save this, then click standard mode, acknowledge this warning, and convert. And now I'm in standard mode and I can make any customization I want. But the file hasn't been saved yet, so I can save as a new name. And close it, then close this converted file, but don't save it. And now I have both versions in case I change my mind. I'll reopen that original file and see it's still in easy mode. That's it for the template gallery in easy mode. Thanks for watching.